Welcome back to Iowa Live, and time to talk a little sports.
Yes.
And you know, we love talking about sports that happen right in our own backyard, and we love talking about the Drake Bulldogs. So we decided we're going to get a hold of this guy right over here. Yeah, you've seen him on TV a lot, ladies and gentlemen. It's the one and only Michael Admire. How are you, buddy?
Yeah. I'm fantastic.
You're back on TV. You tried to get away from TV, and we just dragged you back.
They can't keep me down, right? They can't keep me down. No, it's good to be back. The morning is a little bit different for me, though.
No,
I'm
you
used to being
long?
A late time guy.
Yeah. You spent how long doing sports?
Okay, so I was 18 months at my first job in Southeast Kansas, Southwest Missouri, and I spent about 5.5 years at Channel 13.
Wow.
There you go. And so, tell everybody your new position.
Yeah, I'm now the play-by-play broadcaster for the Drake men's basketball team, and they also hired me on full-time in the athletic department as the director of broadcasting / Drake Sports Media, which is basically their online storyteller.
Nice.
How cool is that?
It's really neat. A great vision by Brian Harden, mm-hmm. the athletic director at Drake, and he's just willing to try new things and just put his own touch on it. And this is a position that was not there before. It was created for me to come in and kind of do what we want with it, and it's been a blast. Thrown into the middle of the season, started in November, and it's just been crazy since.
Now, the play-by-play aspect, that sounds like it's something fairly new for for you. You've never done that before?
You've listened.
Yeah. Honestly, you've never done that before?
I had never done radio play-by-play in my life.
Okay.
But it was something that I just felt like I was ready for a new challenge in my life when it comes to sports broadcasting. And, as things started to transpire last fall, I reached out to Brian. I was like, what are your thoughts on having me in? I was like, I have no experience, but maybe I could help sell the program in a way that's that's never been sold before. And he was up for it. And we have a great team over there with our with IMG Learfield and Paul Dorfeld, my color commentator. He's been there for, I think, 7 years, spending time after Dolph left. Paul came in there, and we took a little bit to get to know each other because we never met. But I think we're rolling now.
What was the hardest part about getting used to doing the radio?
It's preparation.
Yeah,
it's just a different way of preparing for the game. You're each night you have new players on the other team that you're kind of getting used to seeing and trying to.
So what's the process there? How do you remember everybody? Because obviously you use their names. You can't read the back of their jerseys all the time.
Yeah, not all the time. Sometimes,
yeah.
though.
Yeah. But how do you do that? How do you get their names down
pat? Yeah, so it's game film. It's studying the roster as much as you can, getting to know some of their, how they look on the game film. And maybe they're, somebody always wears a ponytail or a headband or whatever it might be. Or you just repetition.
Yeah.
That's exactly what it is.
Getting into it. And you're,
and that's what I think it is.
Yeah.
I mean, I've never done
you're
it
learning.
Before.
You're learning.
It's been working. You're getting more comfortable as the games go on, obviously.
Yeah, it took like 10 games to really feel like, okay, I've got the rhythm and all this stuff down. Now, it's not perfect by any means, but it's I'll put myself out there. So it's fun to kind of, break down a shield and try something new.
Now, are you a fan as well as a broadcaster when you're calling the games?
I try not to be the over-the-top, wee guy, because I didn't practice. I didn't spend the summer hours in the workout room and all that stuff. So I try to stay away from that. But when you're around the team as much as the play-by-play broadcaster is, which was another thing I didn't realize as much until I got into the job. But, when you're around the team as much as we are, you really get to know these guys and love them. And especially with this team, they're such good dudes, from the coaching staff to all the support staff to all the players.
I was going to say, there is an enthusiasm about the team and, Drake Bulldogs, but also this year, they're doing extremely well, it sounds like.
Oh, well, yeah, I already matched the win total from a year ago. Guaranteed a winning season. And this is all without their best player, really. Nick Norton got hurt in the first half of the first game of conference play.
Wow.
The team was rolling 11-2. Best non-conference season since 2008, that magical run in 2008.
Right.
The 11 wins before conference play was the best ever. So, I mean, it was uncharted territory.
Right.
Feeling really good going into conference play with the first-year head coach, and Nick tears his ACL with 5 minutes to go in the first half. Mm. And you're just like, okay, how's this team going to respond?
Right.
And they've responded by finding themselves in, you know, winning 4 out of 5 games, one again this weekend against Indiana State. And now they're in third place.
So, all right, let's take a look at the Indiana State game that you mentioned.
Yeah, let's do it.
Mr. Play-by-Play.
Yeah, okay, all right. Go to work.
There we go. Well,
that's Brady Ellingson in transition pulling up for three right there. Yeah, Brady, a transfer from Iowa, so a lot of the Hawkeye fans know quite a bit about Brady. He has stepped in as a graduate transfer and been fantastic. And then this is our Bulldog right here. Garrett Sturts is one of my favorite players on this team.
Studley Do-Right.
A true freshman out of Newton, Iowa. He was a big-time scorer at Newton, but he comes in and just does everything right. And another freshman, DJ Wilkins, he airballs it there, but check out the hustle by the team and just never giving up on any play. They're a lot of fun. It took them, almost 13 minutes to score more than 10 points. And once they finally broke past that, it got within 3 at halftime and it was kind of back and forth throughout the second half and pulled out a third straight road win. Which,
oh, my goodness.
I mean, you guys know how tough it is traveling and all the schedules when you're on the road, but playing in front of a tough environment. They went into Indiana State and got a third straight road win. So hopefully going for 4 this Tuesday against Loyola. The Ramblers, you know, went to the Final 4 last year.
Right. Mm-hmm.
And so it'll be a tough matchup, but if I know this team, they'll be up for a fight.
Now, what do I get a kick off? I get a kick off how excited you get because it's honest. It's genuine. Some genuine excitement for the Bulldogs.
Well, and this is honest truth. I love television news. It is a passion of mine. Even getting kind of like emotional thinking about it. I just love everything about it. But for me, it was time to try something new. And I've never had so much fun at a job day in and day out than I've had. The deadlines, the stress of the deadlines, they're not there as much. So that helps. But, it's just a new challenge every day and, exposed a little bit and uncomfortable. But that's how you get better in life is by finding yourself uncomfortable. And, man, I'm glad you see that.
No question about it. But people are pretty excited about this weekend, too, because something special is happening this weekend. Tell us what's happening.
Yeah, so the Final Four team from 1969, we're celebrating the 50th anniversary of that team. Mm-hmm. So Dolph Pulliam on that team, of course, and a ton of other fantastic basketball players. I believe 6 NBA or ABA players were drafted from that team.
Wow.
And so, yeah, they're busting out the 1969 throwback uniforms.
Yes.
And this video right here, this is an Iowa Live special.
All
right.
Woo.
It's debuting right now.
So this is the peak of what their uniforms are going to look like, huh?
Yeah, right there.
I love it.
So we're gonna roll those out.
A little sneak peek. Here
on Saturday, it's the powder blue with like a little touch of the red. The detail that went into it was incredible. I mean, to the curves on the shorts, they really put in a lot of effort to make it look as close to that era. Now, it's not, you know, the thick cotton like it was back
which
then.
Which the players are going to appreciate.
Yes,
yeah.
The shorts are a little longer than they were, so Drake is spread out on the shorts a little bit more than they were back then.
Now, the broadcaster's going to wear the uniform, too, or are you going to dress the...
I got to do something, right?
You have to do something different.
I was saying we should all go like 1969.
Absolutely.
Era.
Get the old suit.
Good idea.
Yeah, just old school suit that's like 5 sizes too big for me. A fedora, whatever it might be. The Don Draper kind of.
There you know, go.
Look. I love it.
That could be a lot of fun.
We'll see what we can cook up.
That's nice.
That's wonderful. We don't want to forget about Lady Bulldogs who have had an incredible run as well.
And they've been on just an incredible run for the last 3 seasons.
True.
Back to back Missouri Valley Conference champions. Had a 47-game conference winning streak that was snapped Friday against Missouri State at home, so that was tough. But the girls rebounded, came back yesterday, had a 28-point win. So,
there you go. That's got to be good for them.
Unbelievable. Now, you mentioned a more of an online presence. So where do we need to go to see more of what you're doing behind the scenes?
Just anywhere on Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, any of the Drake websites, especially DU Athletics.
Okay.
You can find us there, DU Bulldog. I should probably have these like written out.
The little thing.
We'll get there. I'm still working on it.
He's doing the play-by-play. So again, you guys are playing tomorrow night, right?
Yeah, it's tomorrow night at Loyola.
Okay, so
we're flying out in like what, 8 hours?
Really?
Oh my goodness.
Non-stop. Okay, we want you to come back and keep giving us updates on Drake. Is that cool?
Let me know. I'll be here.
Good to have you back on TV, dude.
Thanks for stopping by.
Yeah, I appreciate it.
Michael Admire, the voice of the Drake Bulldogs. Again, check it in, and we'll keep an eye on what's happening, Drake, all the way across the board when it comes to athletics. All right.